Okay, everybody, it's Friday, July 1st, 2022, and buckle up. Buckle the freak up. People, let's talk. We are witnessing an incredible phenomenon in the debt market. Forget about the stock market. Honestly, it's the debt freaking freak show market you need to keep your eyes on here. We have witnessed over the last several weeks absolutely unprecedented action here. If you were to just, you know, go glance over at the 10-year yield, you will see that we are now firmly below 3%. As a matter of fact, the last time I looked, it was 2.92. Who's buying the debt? Well, I think we are all well aware of this. We got the ECB now expanding their bond purchasing to other European nations. Their emergency monetary policy, the Federal Reserve in here. It's an incredible thing. And as you all know, this action is massively inflationary, along with the Federal Reserve's reverse repo scheme that is going on, giving the illusion of more liquidity in the system. The system is drying up, okay? That's the truth. Even though the world is awash in debt, beyond anyone's wildest dreams, there's not enough. The system demands that more debt be borrowed into existence, people, by any mechanism possible. You want to speak about a mechanism? We just heard from President Bidenstein, you know, Frankenstein, Frankenmummy, whatever he is, Bidenstein. Well, he's now promising even more money to support the Ukraine war. Imagine my surprise. Yes, you. I don't care what side of the aisle you're on. You have given this president a blank check because no one is doing anything about it. Okay, go ahead. Keep pouring money into this Ukraine war. It's all a scheme, people. This crisis to crisis to crisis, including this war, to pull more cash out of the future. Just, again, to foster this mechanism of debt expansion. It must continue to expand. And henceforth, why you're seeing what central banks are doing right now, creating cash mysteriously out of thin air, buying all the debt, bond yields coming down, 10-year yield cratering. I think you're well aware of this. This is the mechanism, okay? So with a show of hands, how many of you support President Bidenstein funneling even more cash over to Ukraine? You've given him a blank check. And where is the outcry? Oh no, I forgot. They're out protesting Roe v. Wade. Otherwise, they're not doing a damn thing as they get systematically destroyed, people. Our economy is in free fall. You know that. This is a global phenomenon. An entire class of people under attack. And they're not doing a damn thing about it. A damn freaking thing about it. It's absolutely insane. Another piece of information you might want to pay attention to. Bank of America yet again is warning of economic shocks. They're telling people to prepare for economic shocks. Duh. You and I think are well ahead of the curve on this. We know what's going on. Just be ready for anything. Always have the high ground. I've been explaining to people lately that they need to prepare. You need to have food, enough food stored, non-perishables, for at least 6 months. You need a way to defend yourself as well, okay? Ponder these things. Nothing, again, is what it seems to be. And the lies, the propaganda, the distractions, the deceptions are going to get even wilder, okay? You know the narrative here. Our economy is strong. We're booming. Meanwhile, out of their own mouths, they're telling us the polar opposite, and then they're saying, oh, don't believe what we're saying. This phenomenon of how I've explained to you that they are trying to convince you that what you're seeing is not real, I covered this yesterday. Now they're trying to convince you that what they're even saying is also not real. There's some kind of a psyop going on right now. Just understand, people need to come together. Forget about division. They want you to hate everyone and everything. They need to keep you again in some kind of state of disarray, not understanding what's actually going on, so they can foster their agenda here. And their agenda is very simple. Central banks are taking over the world, one world government. Your votes don't matter. If you were allowed to vote and your vote counted, is what I'm trying to say, believe me, you wouldn't be allowed to vote. So forget about what's coming down the pike. I think you're well aware of that. Let's look over at the market again. I already told you about the 10-year yield, 2.92. This is an incredible phenomenon here that we are seeing epic amounts of debt buying. And it's not the regular guy or regular girl who is saying, oh, I got to own that debt. I must own it. I think you're well aware of that. The dollar right now, somewhat stronger. You got silver getting decimated this morning. You got gold under pressure as well. Cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin around 19,000. You got crude oil higher by about 2.5%, a little bit more than that, because OPEC, oh, you're not going to believe this one. You're not going to believe it. But OPEC missed its production target. Oh, really? You mean they're not backing up what they're saying? No, they're determined to keep the price of crude oil higher, people. You all know that. This is a mechanism as well. Oil, crude oil. Absolutely the lifeblood of the military-industrial complex. You know that. They're trying to strangle people to death. And I mean in the literal sense. Anyway, that's the story this morning. But it's, to me, seeing the price action here in the debt market, more specifically the 10-year yield, I can pretty much say in my life, I've never seen this kind of action in the debt market. Just a few weeks ago, again, we were at 3.5 with regard to the 10-year yield. Now we're at 2.9. A 60 basis point move in a matter of a couple of weeks. And, you know, honestly, if you were to turn on even Bloomberg this morning, I'm watching Bloomberg this morning, and they had a female commentator who's actually saying this is pretty incredible what we're seeing. See, once in a while, when they're not reading the script, you know, every single word that they're told to read, you get a little bit of truth out here. But the fact of the matter is, look, I think you're well aware of what's happening, people. This is no secret to anyone. It's just so sick to me. It's so twisted to me. And I want us to more than ever realize, again, what do I tell you? Other than to love each other, to care about each other, and be charitable every single Friday, which I'm going to tell you at the end of the day today. By the way, the market's closed on Monday, but we'll talk about that later. Other than these things I explained to people, we need each other more than ever. We are each other's greatest commodity. You understand? Forget about anything else. I think you're well aware of this. At least I hope, if you've been following my blog. All right, people, look, with that said, today is the first. And the first of every month, I humbly ask for your support. Is Gregory Mannarino doing a good job? Is he trying to make a difference? I think that's pretty obvious. If you believe that's true, please support my work. What do I ask for every month? $5. That's it. If you think I'm doing a good job, in the description of this video, you will see actually two links. One, you could PayPal me $5. I would greatly appreciate it. And yes, of course, I will still accept cryptocurrencies. I still believe in these things. I will get into these yet again at one point. There's no doubt about it. And I will let all of you know. And there's one other thing. If you look right down here, you're going to see a little heart that says thank you. If you don't like PayPal, if you don't want to send me crypto, you can just click on that link somewhere down here. A little heart says thanks. And you can support my work that way. I sincerely hope that you choose to do that. I really do. All right, people, that's it. I'll see all of you at the end of the day. I love you a lot, and I'm out of here.